Hello, this is Naren Daily Timer Model DT-CONT. So this particular timer can be used to turn on and off the loads exactly at the same time every day. So suppose you have any application wherein you want to turn on the load based on the timings, this is the right product. So this has built-in clock, and according to the clock application, you can turn on and off the loads. So we'll just turn on the switch here. This is the on and off switch. So this will always be displaying the current time. So right now the time is 1:17 PM. So that is what it displays. It is a 24-hour format timer. Okay. So this particular timer can be used for street lighting systems or greenhouses wherein you want to turn on and off the lights at evenings, or even the farms, domestic applications. This can also be used to turn on and off the motors, monoblock motors and open well submersible pumps. And also, if you have any specific load applications wherein you want us to design this daily timer, you can always reach to us. We will customize this particular product according to your needs. So this is how it is. Let us go ahead and have a look at the outlook of this timer. This is how the timer looks. We'll have a look at the connections now. So red and yellow wires are the auxiliary supply. You need to give 220 volt supply to this particular timer. Then you have load carrying wires. You have two black wires and two blue wires. These are thicker in size and these carry the load. Alright. So what you need to do is you'll have to take one set of each color wire, one black and one blue, and connect it to the incoming supply, and the other set will go to the load. So I've taken one black and one blue and given it to the incoming supply. So face point is the blue one, neutral point is the black one. So these are the load carrying wires, and the auxiliary connector wires also have been given to the same points. So then you have the other set of wires, the other set of power carrying wires which go to the load. The load I've used here is a small open well submersible motor. You have the starter for which the load goes, and also I've connected a zero candle bulb to this, to the same wires. Okay, so like this you can connect n number of lights based on your this one, based on the capacity of this timer. So I hope connections are clear. So now we will go ahead and have a look at the settings. So this particular daily timer has 8 different time intervals which can be set, I mean to say. So you can set 8 different timings in one particular day. Suppose 8 different times, as in suppose you want the motor to turn on at 6 o'clock from 6 to 7 in the morning, that is one time interval. Then again 10 to 11 in the morning, that is the second time interval. 1 and 2 in the afternoon, that is the third time interval. So like that you can set up to 8 different time intervals. But if your application demands only 1 or 2 time intervals, again you can just specifically set only 2 time intervals also. So before going ahead and having a look at the settings, we need to first clear all the previously set times. So in order to clear all the previously set times, we will press and hold this set button. So before that, we have three different push buttons here. The center one is called set button, the right one is the increase button, and the left one is the decrease button. So pressing and holding this set button, I'm pressing and holding for at least 6 seconds, will clear all the previously set times. So this end indicates all the previously set times are cleared. So holding this button for 5 seconds will trigger out an end on the display, and this will clear out all the previously set times. Now we need to freshly set time according to our application. So setting the time is pretty simple. So as I told you, there are 8 different time intervals. They are categorized into on 1, off 1, that is first interval, on 2, off 2 is the second interval, on 3, off 3 is the third interval. Like that you go up to 8 different time intervals. So let us take an example. So suppose you want the load to turn on at 1:30 in the afternoon, and it should go on till 2:30 in the afternoon. That is on 1 and off 1. Is 1:30 is the on 1, on 2 is 2:30. Similarly, if you want have some other time in the evening, 4 to 5 p.m. That is on 2 and off 2. I'll just show you how to make those settings. I'll first press the set button. It will indicate on 1. So on 1. So in order to set the time, you'll press the increase button. Pressing and holding this button will scroll the timings faster. So I want the load to turn on at, say, suppose 2 p.m. I'll set it at 14. So 2 to 3, I'll just set the load to 2 to 3 p.m. So 14. So this is on 1. So it should turn off at 3 p.m. So that will be again 15. So I'll press and hold, long press. Mm-hmm. So yeah, this is 15 will be the 2 to 3 one time interval has been set. I'll press the set button again. It will just show on 2 now. On 2 is the second time interval. Suppose I want the second time interval to be at around maybe 4 to 5 as I told you. So 4 o'clock is 12 plus 4, that is 16. So 16 is the on 2. Similarly, it turns on off 2 will be 5 o'clock, that will be 17. So I'll press and hold. So like this you can set n 8 number of time intervals. So I need 2 intervals then, just for an example. So this is the second. Once this timing is set, this is the 5 o'clock, I'll just press and hold this continuously. Pressing and hold this continuously, on 3 I'm not bothered, on 3 I don't want, I'm still holding this button till I read end. So you read end. So what this means is we have set 2 different time intervals. Among 8 intervals, we have just set 2 time intervals. One is between 2 to 3 and the second one is between 4 to 5. So like that you can set up to 8 different time intervals. So all the remaining time intervals can be left blank. So before setting the time anytime, you need to clear all the previously set times and then only set the time which you need. I hope things are clear, and this is it. Every time it will be, yeah. And one more thing which we need to bring to your notice is this. Suppose for example you've set the time at around, now you have set the time between 2 to 3 p.m. right, the first interval. Suppose let us assume there is a power cut at 2 o'clock and there is no power. The power gets back only at 2:30 p.m. let us assume. So that in that case the load will be turned on till 3 p.m. I mean it is in the window between 2 to 3 is the window. So there is no power at 2 o'clock. Power comes at around 2:30. So this window, whatever it is, 2:30 to 3, this window the load will turn on. Similarly, so inside that window, whenever there is power cut, for whatever the remaining time the power is there, the load will be turned on. If the power is not there for the entire time interval, then that's when the time will be bypassed and you might lose out of turning on the load in that applications. So I hope things are clear. Now we'll just demonstrate about a small 1 minute time interval just to see how it works. So right now the time is 1:24. I'll just set on 1 to be 1:26 and on 2 to be 1:27. Okay. So press this on 1 to be 1:26. So I'm reducing the time. On 1 is 1:26. Set this of 1 to be 1:27. So 1:27, I'm just going back. I'll press and hold, long press will trigger an end. So I'm not bothered about on 2 now. Yeah, so first time interval is set. So accordingly, so 1:26 is the on time now, and 1:27 it should turn off. So now, right now the time is 1:25, and this has a small battery, the watch battery inside for the clock, just in case after a few years if the battery goes down, you can always replace the battery and you can get the timer working. So I hope the connections are clear. So we're just waiting for the time. So 1:26, that's when the load should turn on. So we have a bulb as well as the motor connected in parallel to the output. So this daily timer has many applications. So right now you can just see the load turned on, the light also turned on, and the motor as well. The motor is running, so you can see it on the LED here. Okay, so 1:26 is the time the motor turned on. So at 1:27, the load will be automatically turned off, because that is when we have set the off time. So yeah, there are, as I told you, there are many different applications of daily timer which we'll have to figure out. Any application which requires the load to be turned on every day at that particular time, we have this daily timer. And daily timer are available for submersible pumps as well as three-phase submersible pumps. We have different varieties in this. Please don't hesitate to contact us. So you can always reach us on www.narenelectrics.in Also, you can make a note of our contact number. It's 99722-43774. I repeat, it's 99722-43774. Yeah, right now the time is 1:27 and the load turned off. Yeah, I hope everything is clear. Thank you so much for watching this video.